So we're inside the tavern at Dawnstar. Erendir's telling people to relax, settle down.
I envy you, travelers. Dreams aren't affecting anyone. Not
she keeps singing. I can't get her to quit singing.
Sure, my voice could use a rest.
He's trying to help us.
Everyone, please. I'm doing what I can to end these nightmares. In the meantime,
I
ask is you remain strong and put your trust in Lady
Mar. I understand. I will. Thank you.
And when I did that with the vampire wings, all I did was reset the bard to start singing again after she's done playing her drums.
What troubles you, my daughter?
So I probably shouldn't have done that. Maybe that's why she kept singing when I told her not to.
All right, then.
Usually these people all walk away after he's said what he's gonna say. Really? Livia, shut up! Shut up!
As he told of bold battles and gold he had made.
The Windpeak Inn features the finest bard in all of Dawnstar. Me.
But maybe this happens if you come to Dawnstar at night. If you come to Dawnstar during the day, I think everyone's sandboxes have things to do. Oh, come on. Shut up!
I understand.
And the braggart did swagger his blade as he told the bold bat.
I envy you, travelers. Sure, what can I do for you? Yes.
At least play a better song.
Our hero claims a warrior's heart. I tell you, Dragonborn comes.
I thought maybe the crowd would disperse if I came outside and did some murdering. Because there were some people standing around out here earlier. That usually means that there's enemies in town and they're trying to hide somewhere. This is my first time at Dawnstar, so there's probably going to be a lot of outdoor encounters happening at once. You know, vampires, werewolves, dragons, bandits, wolves, trolls, thugs. What's another one that comes through here?
How can I argue with that?
Let's see, what powers did she give me?
A life without faith is a life without beacon.
I like the HD fire that my game has in it now. I'm trying to remember, what mod do I have? Oh, it's the my E and B that I'm using. Replaces all the fire in the game.
Need something?
At first I didn't like this ENB because
I'm late, gotta run!
It's more than an ENB. It changes animation textures. And I didn't want that to happen. I just wanted to change the render settings of the game. But it changes textures in the game as well. But after a while, I thought, you know what? It looks better than ever, so I'm keeping the EMB installed. Meanwhile, he's still standing here.
The entire town is being plagued by horrible nightmares.
So I figured I might as well do the quest. Otherwise, these people will never leave the tavern for the rest of the game.
These dreams are manifestations. She has an. I must end her terrible.
I'm just going to fast forward through all this because we all know how this quest starts.
I've already said too much. I would simply ask that you try. Wonderful. Nightcaller Temple is only a short walk from Dawnstar. Come, we must hurry.
See, now everyone leaves now. Oh, they're in their mind, they're thinking, oh, they're going to go fix the problem now. We can leave. Okay, good. So now they can go sandbox outside and do whatever it is that they're supposed to do. Otherwise, their quests get messed up outdoors. I'm a completist, I guess you could say. I like my Skyrim to all the little, I like all the encounters to end nicely, not half-assed. Because I hate looking in my save file and I see quest jams. Quests that never finished that are still in the save file. I got credit for it, but the quest is still kind of lingering. I hate that. Because if a quest never ends, then anything that died during that quest never goes away. It lays in the street forever. Because usually when a quest will end, it cleans up all the dead bodies afterwards that were created during the quest. Which is kind of cool, but kind of annoying if the object-oriented bubbles no longer stay nested. Like those Russian, not those Russian things, what are they called? Those little egg figures. It's usually a woman. She's egg-shaped, and she's hollow, and you open her up, and there's a smaller version of her inside, and then you open her up, and there's a smaller version of her inside, and you end up with like 10 of these figure things, and they all fit inside each other. That's what object-oriented NPC quests are like. Every object has an object inside of it. But what happens with Skyrim sometimes is
Ironbreaker mine is three
times one of the eggs gets outside. It's, you know, the thing's all closed up and you got this one object outside of the other objects. And it no longer wants to fit inside the puzzle anymore.
One of the miners. I don't want any trouble.
And you're trying to figure out how to get that egg to get back inside with the rest of the eggs.
It's hilarious that the Thalmor
can't sleep well no matter how much
they still proudly use the coins that have his face sculpted.
I'm no one. Yeah.
Anyway, they're waiting for something else to be said before they say their thing. Usually they have something to say out here. We're at war with your husband? You know, that kind of thing. I'm not going to worry about that. That quest is so minor, what they're talking about. Meanwhile, this guy's waiting for me to follow him. I'm just going to fast forward this whole quest, because we all know how it is. So here we are at the end of the quest. We destroyed the skull thing, because I've never figured out how that skull thing works. And I don't need the Daedric item, so. We won. He lives. He walks away with the little sparklies falling from his fingertips, which I think is pretty cool. I only notice it when I have an EMB installed. In vanilla Skyrim, I never noticed anything coming from his fingertips, but he's got these little white sparkly
all
things.
Right,
I don't know what that effect is called, but it's kind of cool. Only he has it in the game, I think. I've never seen that from another NPC before, that I can recall. So everyone's dreams are squashed, crushed. In my last playthrough, I noticed there was a door that I couldn't open. It's right about here somewhere. Yeah, this door right here. I could not open this door for the life of me in my last playthrough. It's like, how do I get out? How do I get in there? But it's a level issue or a map issue. I'm not sure why, but everyone's naked. After I kill people, they're all naked. I don't know why. I don't know what mod's doing that. All the orcs and everybody are naked. I don't know why. Avert your eyes if you don't like nakedness. But it's only when I'm looking at this area from that side of the door. If I'm in the other side of the door, I think they have their clothes on still. I'm not 100% sure, but I need to... Anyway, I eventually figured out how to get over there so I can open up that lock, so I can come out that door, so I can... It's just a minor thing, but... I just don't know why there's the naked people everywhere. I didn't take their stuff. They should still have their clothes on. Yeah, so if I come running down here... Okay, now here's... So there's a way out this way, which I didn't know. I don't know if that makes the quest any better or different or what, coming out this way. Because you don't go this way during the quest. You have to go into the bowels. Into the bowels of the fort. To get to the skull dream snatcher item. Because he walks this way. He doesn't walk the way I just came. Anyway. Maybe he'll walk the way I came if I had that door open already. Who knows? The point is, I finished this quest. Done. Quest complete.